Hello, this is Jeff from Baron Leathercraft, and today we're going to be using a 10-watt laser with the Afiro Laser 2 to see if it's going to be able to cut out your patterns and the stitching holes. We already know it does some really cool designs, but you want to be able to cut out those patterns and the stitching holes. So I did a bunch of tests. Let's see what kind of pitfalls we can run into, and let's also find out the optimum settings. So let's take a look. All right, the concept of this test is to find out whether you're able to cut patterns and stitching holes with a diode laser. In this case, I'm using the Afiro Laser 2, and it is a 10-watt laser. So in Lightburn, which is the software that I use to run my laser, I set up a bunch of tests, and this is going to be the outcome of the tests. I'm going to start off with the worst-case scenario, in the sense that's a setting that you wouldn't want to use. Now here is a 4,000 millimeters a minute, which is relatively fast. It's too fast for cutting with a diode laser, you know, for something like this. I have it set at 100% power and four passes. Four passes means it'll cut the same spot four times, digging deeper as it goes. I found out with the 10-watt laser, this isn't necessary. It actually cuts up to 10-11 ounce leather easily. It probably will go thicker than that, actually. All right, so this is... this is 7-8 ounce leather. And if you notice all the burn marks around the holes, that's unacceptable unless you're looking for that look. It has a cool rustic appeal, but you want your laser cutout to be as clean as possible so you can make the choices of what you want to do. So I found out pretty quickly with this laser, you don't need to do more than one pass. For example, let's just make sure the thickness of this. Yeah, this is also 7-8. And this is at 300 millimeters a minute, 100% power, and one pass. It's a lot slower, but look how much cleaner it is. This is acceptable. I could use this. Especially if I was going to go ahead and dye it, I wouldn't even ignore this. Plus, most of this subtle burn that you see around the holes, the stitch is going to go over that anyway. So 300 millimeters a minute, 100% power, one pass. This was pretty successful. Plus, just to let you know that these holes are 1 millimeter. So I was able to cut 1 millimeter holes very well. And these holes basically fell out. Sometimes the leather will stick in there and you got to poke it through. But it was with this setting, I just flicked it at most and they came right out. Here's an example. This is the one we were just looking at. And here's one. It appears to be the same leather. This one was done at 500 millimeters, so it was a little faster. And you can see the burn was a lot more prominent. So just that setting change, you know, seems to have caused a little more burn. The color of the leathers look different, so I'm going to guess that they might be from either a different section of the same hide. It's the same thickness. They're both 7-8, but this is what happened when I used the 500 millimeter. So there's a few variables that could have caused that difference, of which I'm not positive of. Now this first row here, this is all 3 ounce leather, and I went ahead and changed the speed by increments. Now the top one is 500 millimeters a minute, 100% power, one pass. And these holes are 1 millimeter. This came out nice. This is usable. See how clean that is? I could use that, especially if I was dyeing. Using dye. The second one is at 600, and these holes are 1.5 millimeter. This really came out nice too. This is usable. So definitely go with one pass. Obviously, I forgot to take off the E there, because obviously I was making ones like this that said passes, and I just changed the words. This is at 700. Now, the difference here is the holes didn't fall right out, but those will poke right through. They're ready to fall out. This one is at 800. It's at one pass, 100% power. You can see as I sped up the machine, it left more of a burn around the holes. So for me, this 500 with one pass, 100% power, and this 600, I'm really liking this 600. Now for the heavy hitter. I was actually really happy with the outcome of this. This is at 200 millimeters a minute, 100% power, and one pass. And look how thick that is. It barely fits into 1011. I don't know if you can see that. So this is basically definitely at least 10, leaning towards 11. Look how clean the holes are. This is one pass. So it went through this 11 ounce leather with the holes pretty easily. Let me see if you could see the holes. Yeah. So this was impressive because I was concerned. I didn't think that it was going to cut through the 10 ounce leather so well and so cleanly. For these letters, I use 7,000 millimeters a minute and 60% power, which is something I found on leather to be nice for letters, for any text. All right, so what's going on here? If you notice, it came out really clean near the holes. That's really clean. But you see how the text came out wacky? You know, it's like what I used with this was something called transfer paper. And transfer paper actually goes over the leather with a very mild adhesive. Actually, the adhesive is so mild that it doesn't affect the leather. As a leather crafter, you guys probably know, whenever you add adhesive to a piece of leather and pull it off, it leaves some of the adhesive onto the leather. And then when you go to dye it, it comes out in a weird pattern because it's being blocked by the adhesive. So if you're looking for that look, it actually, I've used it before, it's pretty cool looking. But if you don't want that, you can't use tape on your leather. So this was a very medium tacked transfer paper, which I'll show you a clip of right now. And because of that, it doesn't affect your dyeing capabilities. But if you were going to use it, in my experience, it really helped keep the holes clean. You could see there's like no burn around the holes, just the hole itself. And the stitching is going to take care of that. But it definitely warped the text. So look deeper into that. I might not be using the transfer paper properly. I have to look at some other YouTube videos or find somebody else that is using transfer paper on leather. I've seen videos of it working with wood. I've used it on wood. It works with wood. But I'm getting this unusual look on the text as far as leather is concerned. So basically, once again, this is what it came down to. I really like this. Is both of the top ones are 3 ounce leather. They both came out nice. They're both usable. It seems like the 500 millimeter a minute is cleaner, though the holes are smaller than the one with the 600 millimeters. This is 7/8 leather. It's at 300 millimeters a minute, 100% one pass. This is really clean. I was happy with the outcome. This is what I would use. My favorite is actually the thickest leather. This is the 10/11 ounce leather. I did it at 200 millimeters a minute, 100% power, and one pass. All four of these I could use to cut out patterns I'd be happy with. It's a matter of just tweaking it at that point. One reason why the 11-ounce leather might look so good is because of the actual color of the leather. This is Herman Oak leather, and this is what I use 90% of the times that I do my tooling. It's very possible that the very color of the leather is what is masking any form of smoke residual. This is something you might want to keep in mind when you're purchasing leather for the laser engraver. I personally love the color of the Herman Oak leather. I think this is what most people expect when they come across leather, this tone right here. As far as the use of transfer tape, it really came out clean. Those are the cleanest holes, in my opinion. But if you notice what it did to the pattern, as far as the text goes, I'm going to have to figure out why that's happening and whether there's a cure for that. But if you were not going to put if you just wanted to cut out patterns and you didn't put a design on it with your laser, using the transfer paper actually creates for really clean holes. Alright, now I have a much better idea of what kind of settings I need when I decide to cut out patterns and stitching holes. It's a lot quicker to use the laser than it is to cut it by hand. There's certain things you're going to want to cut by hand, I'm sure. I was hoping that it was going to be able to cut out the stitching holes. I wasn't really sure. You don't know the limits of the laser, so I'm glad that I can cut out certain patterns and the stitching holes. It's great. Maybe a good example is actually the pattern that's being cut out right now on the screen. I could never cut that out as accurate as the laser, so I could see the benefits of using this for cutting certain things out. Hey, thank you for watching this video. I love sharing this information. Plus, I love playing with all my gadgets, including the video editing. I just love learning all this stuff and, you know, just utilizing it. I truly appreciate you guys watching this video. I would really appreciate if you'd subscribe to the channel, send me a like, that would be great. It really does help and benefit everyone that has a channel when you subscribe. So I hope you learned something, and I got more videos coming. Take care, and thanks again.